Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be talking about how you can make more realistic-looking grass using Lumion 9. Okay, so I'm going to be using SketchUp just for this first part here. What I did is I made a flat plane, I made it green, and then I imported this gnome who is pushing a wheelbarrow through the grass. It's a pretty cool looking model, so I think it might be cool if we're going to put in some grass, why not have a garden gnome? So we have that guy in there, and that's pretty much it. I just saved this, and then I'm going to be using Lumion Sync to bring this into Lumion. Okay, so I've imported the little gnome here. I'm using the standard white background scene. So you can see my grass here, and here's my little gnome. Now what I'm going to do, typically in previous versions, you'd use the landscape tools to put in some grass. But in Lumion 9, there's actually a 3D grass texture. So that's what we're going to be using here. So you click on this little texture image or this material image. It'll bring up materials. We'll enable them. Then you can click on the surface, and then it'll give you an option. You can make your own, but the 3D grass is under nature. And then you'll see here there's 3D grass. And then I'm just going to choose Wild Grass 1. That's going to give me this guy. It's a little much. So let's choose something a little different. Let's choose Clean Cut here. And then I'll just make it a little bit longer. So just double click that. And then choose Grass Length. And just make it a little bit taller. Add some gravity. Add some bending. Try to get the front of that wheel a little bit. And just make it a little bit curly. So it looks pretty good. So that's a good start. But what I've noticed, and you could render like this, and I've done that before. But what I've noticed to really make some realistic grass is that you need to add some other things into this. So just to give it a little bit more texture. So if you go to Objects, under Nature, you want to do place here. I'll bring up the menu here. There's like these little white flowers that I really love. So I usually just hit the search icon at the top and then type in white. So there are these little guys, these little Gricken guys, or these bird's eye primrose, white grouped. You click them. So this is like ginormous, so let's just scale them down. Just click scale, scale them down to like that. Go back to select, and then bring them down. And the way that I sort of do this is I just want them peeking up a little bit. Something like that. Now when I select this, choose move, move horizontal. I'm gonna hit Alt here. I'm just going to make a copy, and I can make like a little cluster of these, right? And then select them. Select the group of them, and then make a few groups of these off. So I have like three little groups, which makes it the grass a little bit more dynamic. What I can also do is come in. What I like to do is type in grass. And then just put some like wild grass in here and there. So like this rough grass insert, this is probably, this might be something that's like good off in the distance. We're just kind of see what might work for your particular grass. Just to give it a little bit of variety. Simple grass, probably not. Okay, yeah, so where it says thick grass cluster, let's do like a smaller patch. Something like that. And then we'll just scale this down again. So just select that and then scale like this. And you may want to change the hue a little bit so it matches or is similar to what is already there. I think really it's mostly about changing the saturation in this particular case. It looks pretty good. And the same thing, select it, move it, and then choose the up arrow and move it down a little bit just so it is picking up just a tiny bit. So then take this, hit Alt, and then you can make a few copies of that around as well. And that should give you a pretty convincing grass with a little bit of variation. You can do this, you know, a few different times with other types of grass, and we'll just give it that variety that is in real grass. But I think these like little things help add a little bit of variety to the grass itself. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.